I'm Gail Locke McDowell, author of Cracking the Coding Interview. In this video, we're going to cover some of the basics of recursion. So recursion is a concept, not a data structure nor an algorithm, but a way that we solve a problem. So let's suppose we have this problem. You have a computer and you want to know how many .txt files are there on this computer. Well, you can certainly go into the root directory and count how many are there, but then it has folders and each of those folders has subfolders and so on and so on. So you need to actually go out and ask all of them and find all of the .txt files across the whole computer, which is a bit annoying until we do this recursively. So when we do it recursively, what we do is we say, okay, we might count how many files are in our root directory, but then we go and add up how many are in each folder, and we go and ask them in the very same process, hey, how many .txt files do you have? And they then know to go out and ask their subfolders and so on and so on. And that's what recursion is. So in this case, what happens is the following. We first call my computer and ask my computer, how many .txt files do you have? It says, well, I have two in my immediate folder, but then in order to get my final answer, I need to go ask homework, pictures, and music. So first we go ask homework and we say, homework, how many files do you have? And that's what's called recursing. And homework says, well, let's see. I have one .txt file, but now let me go check with project one and project two. So we go to project one, we do the same thing. And eventually, if we do this enough times, we'll go through all of our folders and all of their subfolders and so on, until we get through all of the files and get our final answer, which in this case is 8. So recursion is just a way of taking a problem and breaking it down into subproblems. And then each of those subproblems is generally broken down into more and more and more subproblems. Of course, if we did this forever and we didn't have a stopping case, then, well, we would do it forever. So every recursion must have what's called a base case or like a stopping point. In this case, the base case is when we have a folder with no subfolders. Then we'll just return once we count out how many files it has. But let's look at another example. The Fibonacci sequence is one of the simplest examples of recursion. In fact, we often say that the Fibonacci sequence is defined recursively. But this definition in and of itself doesn't make a lot of sense. We need a starting point. We need to know what is f of 0 or f of 1. Implementing this recursively is now actually very natural. So this code will call fib of n, and that'll then recurse to fib of n minus 1 and fib of n minus 2. Eventually, it'll get back those answers and add those up and return that value. When we call, say, fib of n minus 1, it'll then do the same thing and recurse and recurse and recurse. We'll stop when we get down to the base cases, which are when n is 0 or 1. So let's walk through this with a more concrete example. So suppose we call this for fib of 4. Well, fib of 4 will call fib of 3 and fib of 2. Fib of 3 will call fib of 2 and fib of 1. Fib of 2 will call fib of 1 and fib of 0. Okay, now this fib of 1 will return 1. Fib of 0 will return 0. And fib of 2 will get back an answer of 1. Now fib of 3 will get this answer back of 1. This other fib of 1 will return 1 also, and it'll return 2 for fib of 3. Then fib of 4 has called fib of 3. Now it has to compute fib of 2. Fib of 2 goes out to call fib of 1, and that's it hits a base case, so it returns 1. Fib of 0 hits another base case and returns 0. So fib of 2 returns 1. And then fib of 4 just has to add up this 2 and this 1 to get back an answer of 3. And so that computes the fourth value in the Fibonacci sequence of 3. So one thing you might have noticed is that we're repeating work. We compute fib of 2 here, and then we get back the value of 1 there, but then we also repeat the work here. And that's true, we do. And so this implementation of Fibonacci can get very, very inefficient. Now there's two things to know here. One is there is a way of optimizing this using a technique called memoization, and we'll cover that in a different section. Another thing to note is that there's a very well-known theorem that basically states that anything that is implemented recursively can be implemented iteratively. The reason why we often use recursion is that for certain problems, the recursive implementation is a lot easier to read and understand and write than an iterative explanation.
It doesn't mean that we always want to use recursion or we always don't want to use iteration. It really just depends on the problem. So this means for you in your interview is it's very much a case-by-case decision. Sometimes you want to implement the iterative solution, and other times you want to implement the recursive solution. But generally, your interviewer will be in there in the room with you, and so you don't have to decide it by yourself. You can ask your interviewer. Recursion is a super popular topic for interviews, so I really, really encourage you to spend a lot of time really practicing and making sure you understand it. So with that said, why don't you try out some recursive problems yourself? Good luck.